today's job is doing the drainage behind this retaining wall. So what I've done is I've leveled across from this level here, come down 6 inches, strong line all the way from the top down to the bottom. I mean, if you can see, well, that membrane was stuck to the wall with sticks all, but it's fallen off, but don't worry, I'll sort that out. But yeah, if you can see, I've blackjacked the wall on that angle, and that goes all the way up to the top, which waterproofs the backside of the wall below ground. Be very careful when you're doing that, that you don't get carried away with the paintbrush, because you do not want to paint the face bricks. We only had 2 meter wide membrane, so I've run one from this side down, up, stuck it to the wall, and then a second sheet then laid over and into the bottom. So now I'm just gonna set my fall with the chippings for the perforated pipe, work all that out. I'm waiting for the rest of the gravel. I got a ton bag at the moment left over, so I'm just gonna probably just chuck that in there for now. At least it'll hold the matting down in the bottom of the trench, and then when the rest comes, we'll put a fall on it for the drainage chippings. So all my gravel got delivered. So now I've got a perforated pipe to go behind this wall, and I need to calculate the fall that ends where this wall is going to go across as well. Eventually I want a 1 in 80 fall, so to calculate that you have to find the overall run. So my run eventually is going to be 21 meters, because I'm going to be finishing over in that corner there. To get 1 in 80 fall, you divide 1 by 80, and then you times that by 21, and that gives you the overall amount that has got to drop between the point you start to the point you finish. So I've worked that out, and it's 262 millimeters. The lowest point over there we'll call 0, which is the height of my weep holes, and then the highest point is going to be 262 mil higher than that. I hope you understand this. What 1 in 80 means is for every 80 units, so let's call it centimeters, millimeters. Okay, for every 80 centimeters in horizontal run, the pipe has to drop 1 centimeter. That's probably the easiest way to explain it. I'm going to be filling in this section all the way down to that corner, right? I'm starting from this column here because the ground's so low there, it's going to have drainage chippings. It doesn't really need the pipe. From this point, I know I have to be 262 mil. The bottom of this course is the finish point, going to be over in that corner. Just need to measure up 262 mil, which I believe is somewhere here. This point, my chippings are going to be that high. So then to calculate 7 meters down where it's going to be at the other end, I go 1 divided by 80 and then times it by 7, and that works out 86 mil, I think. So from this point to that point, I need to be 86 mil lower on the corner there than here. Oh my God. It's no wonder I'm not a teacher, isn't it? Because I'm terrible at this. That's me set out now. This point here, which is the start of the pipe, is 87 mil higher than the corner point where we're going to for now, because this wall is getting continued all the way across to there. I mean, you can do this with a laser, but to be honest, I've got a reference point here, which is the underside of these capping stones. My calculations said it's a 1 in 80 fall, so that's spot on, really. So now I've just got to backfill this up to that line by eye, form the gradient with the chippings, and then we'll put the pipe in. That's that little job done. As you can see, I literally just did it with a string line, really. I mean, all you got to make sure is the string line freely wobbling without getting caught, and it's just hovering above that, so that looks pretty nice and flat and level. So it's time to put the pipe in.
Right, well,
finish wrestling with this giant anaconda. Worth mentioning, it's probably easier to do it with two people. Weighted this end down with some chippings. I was going to say, it's important in a perforated pipe to put your perforations underside. But this seems to have perforations all the way around. My customer ordered this and usually they're just on the bottom, on one side. So all I'm going to do now is backfill this with chippings. About, I don't know, 4 inches from the top of this trench that tapers down. And then the landscaping fabric then folds over to create a filter to stop the silt from all this topsoil that's going to go on seeping through and blocking your drains.
Once you've finished backbreaking work of filling all that with gravel, you've just got to entomb it then in your landscaping fabric all the way down. And then that's ready for some topsoil and grass seed now. Just blend it into the lay of the land, I guess.